video, we are going to see tenses in English, okay? So I already would have learned about something about tenses. So normally tenses means the action which is being taken place at what time. So that will be denoted by certain tenses. So here we have three types of tenses. Normally we have present tense, past tense and future tense. Now we are going to see in detail about simple present tense. Okay, so now a sentence is presented in simple present tense when it is used to describe an action that's happening at present, that means at that time, and does not indicate when the action is expected to end. Some simplest present tense is used when the action that is taking place in general, the action not only occurring now, it repeats after regular interval of time. Okay, next one, to indicate facts, those are generally true. The action for relating habits and routines that happen all the time, be it in the future, past or present. So action can be at any time, but present tense means the action which is taking place at that time while speaking. Okay, so that is what is present tense. Present, the action being taken at that right time. Okay, so now we'll see in detail about certain things about present tense. So now you have any tense or any sentence can be written in three forms. One is affirmative, negative and interrogative. Okay, so now I have given you the conjugation of a verb called walk in affirmative form, negative form and interrogative form. So here we can see the verb walk takes an S in particularly in affirmative when it comes to the third person singular. So I is your first person, you is your second person, he or she or it is third person singular. Now next one is we, first person plural, you second person plural, and third person plural is they walk. Same thing when you go for negative, you can write I don't walk. So same thing goes on, but here the verb doesn't change, it remains same everywhere. Okay, but only the thing is when you go for the third person singular, that is he, she, it, because of don't we use doesn't. Okay, he doesn't or she doesn't or it doesn't walk. Okay, next one, same thing here. When you ask question, interrogative means question, everywhere you can go with the do, but except with the third person singulars, that is he or she or it. Okay, so here you see there, everywhere you can say do I walk, does he walk, does she walk, does it walk. So that is the change you have to remember. So any sentence can be written in three forms. One is affirmative, negative and interrogative. Now we'll go in detail about the conjugation. Now you see verb conjugation and spelling. We form the present tense using the base form of the infinitive verb. That is, infinitive means without any conjugation. To write, we say, no, to write. That is what we take out to, TO. Now, in general, in the third person, we add S in the third person. That is what? Third person, normally I told you before itself. He or she or it, we change or we add S for the, any verb. So here you can see the tabular column. I have given the subject, verb and the rest of the sentence. Now you see I, you, we, they. So they don't come under. So I is what? First person you, second we, first person plural, they, third person plural. So they don't have any S or anything. Just they have the same verb, speak or learn, anything you can say. So I speak English at home, or you speak English at home, they speak English at home, I learn English at home, like that it goes on. But he, she or it. So here you can see there is an S being added to the verb. So that is how the changes goes on. Okay, so you have to remember this point especially in a particular manner. Okay, the spelling of the verb in the third person differs depending on the ending of the verb. So now there is another problem, because if there is a difference in ending of the verb, that is ending, the last two words or in last two letters or anything, so that can change the things. Now we'll see in detail about that also. See, now if the verbs are ending in O or CH, SH or SS or X or Z, we add ES to the third person. Third person means what I said already, he or she or it. So here equal go, so it ends in O, so AES is added, goes. Catch, CH, ES is added. Wash, SH, ES is added. KISS, kiss, ES is added. So now same thing, fix, buzz, everywhere you can see that is what I said. So the words are which are ending in, you have to remember this particular thing, very important. O, CH, SH, SS or X or EZ, we add ES to the third person singular. Okay, now we'll go to the next one. Here we have another format. For the verbs that end in consonant Y, so there are different types of consonant Y and vowel Y. So if there is a consonant Y at the end of the verb, there we take out that Y and add IES. So here you see marry, marries, study, studies, carry, carries, worry, worries. So like this we change it. And note, same thing, if there is a vowel Y, we just add S. See, like play, play, plays, enjoy, enjoys, say, says. So these three things you have to remember, okay? The verbs which are ending, endings are very important. See to that and change according to that, the third person alone. Third person means already I am telling he, she or it, not anywhere else, okay? Now we'll go in detail. Now we have four format of simple present. So now we'll go with the simple present. It is used to denote scientific fact, universal truth and work done on daily basis. Daily basis means every day, then and there, at present. At present means the action happening at that time when you are speaking. So now we'll have another floor classification. One is assertive rule, means it is for affirmative form, negative form, interrogative form, then interrogative, negative, affirmative. So these are the four type of sentence you can write for simple present. So here you can see the alignment of the formation of the particular sentence. First we'll go for the affirmative form, that is called assertive rule. Subject, V1 means verb 1. Verb 1 means which is normally presented in present tense. Then S or ES is added plus object. So that is the rule. Okay. So she writes a letter. So that is a sentence. Next one, negative rule. Subject, does not. Or we can already have given you the affirmative negative sentence. So you can see the V1 means again the present tense of the verb. The S or ES which has been added or changed according to the third person. That also depends on the verb, okay. Next one is object. So that is the rule. So she does not write a letter. Next one, interrogative means asking question. So here does plus verb plus V1 plus S or ES plus object. So that means does she write a letter. So that is how it goes on. Next one is interrogative negative. So the question is asked in negative but affirmative form. So here assertive. Next one, does plus subject plus not, then the V1, then S or ES plus object. So does she not write a letter? So that is how it goes on. So these are the rules you have to remember carefully. So this will be followed for all the classification. Okay, next we'll go. We have present continuous. So we saw simple, now it is present continuous. Continuous means the action is going on. It is used to express an action taking place at the time of speaking. So that means it is going on and it has been continuing. So first one, assertive, affirmative form, subject plus is or am or are. So this verb is to be. To be is conjugated in this particular format according to the subject pronouns. So I told you, I, you, he or she or it, you, we, you, they. So like that we have the subject pronouns. According to this, the verb will be conjugated. Okay. So now is, am, are, anything you can write. So here, these three things will be replaced and after that we have to write verb, which is the main verb to the V1 form, that is present tense. Then that has to be written in ing form. So continuous, adding ing to the verbs plus the object. Okay, so here you can see the example, she is writing a letter. Okay, so that is what I, writing, so that is the verb, see ing is added. Then negative form, subject plus is or am or are plus not, V1. That is added in the ing plus object. So she is not writing a letter. Very simple sentence. Okay, you can easily understand. Then interrogative rule, is, on, am or are plus subject plus V1 plus ing. That is the verb written in ing form plus object. So here she is writing, is she writing a letter? She is she writing a letter? Okay, now this is the interrogative. Next one, same thing, interrogative negative. Next one we have, is she not writing a letter? Is she not writing? So same thing, is, am, or plus subject. Then comes not, then the V1 verb with the ing plus object. So this is how the rules goes on. So if you have this format in your hand always, it will be simple for you to understand whatever tense is given to you in particularly regarding to this particular subject topic. Okay. Now next we'll go for the present perfect. So present perfect is a little bit different. It is used to show an action that has started in the past and has just finished. So that means has just finished. I have just taken, like that it goes on. So here, first one is assertive, means affirmative form, subject plus has or have. That is to have the verb. To have is the verb which is conjugated throughout in this particular present perfect. So we use to have as an auxiliary verb. So this verb is changed. Like I have, you have, or he or she has, we have, you have, they have. Okay, and then the verb 3. Verb 3 is what? Past participle of the given verb. So the verb will be changed to past participle. Past participle means maximum will end in ed. Okay. So then plus the object. Here you can see the ed or en, anything. So there are some, you have some exceptionals in that past participle. You would have learnt earlier itself. She has written a letter. So now you can see the she has. Because since everything is kept in third person, it is has. Normally if I write in first person, it has I have or you have. Only for third person singular, that is he or she or it, will come has. Okay. The next one is negative rule. Subject plus have, that is has or have, plus not, plus the verb 3. That is verb 3 means past participle form plus object. So she has not written a letter. Okay. See, I have taken write as the verb here. So I am writing written. If I would have taken some close, like that means it is closed. So par speak means spoken. Like that, certain words you have past participle. So you can use the past participle. That is the V3 form. Okay. Next one is interrogative rule. So here has or have should come. That is the auxiliary verbs comes first, then the subject. That is inversion type. Plus verb 3 plus object. Verb 3, you have to remember past participle. So has she written a letter? Okay. Has she written a letter? Then interrogative negative rule, has or have plus subject plus not plus verb 3 plus object. So here, has she not written a letter? So these are the four formats you have to remember always for any tense. Okay. Now next we'll go for present perfect continuous. So from the word itself you can understand it is still continuing. Okay. The tense shows the action which started the past and is still continuing. Here you have the affirmative form, that is called assertive rule, subject. Here you have has or have, okay, plus been, that is added here. So in present perfect you saw only has or have, but here it is after has and have you are adding another word been everywhere. Then only we use, but the verb in present perfect we use V3, but here we use V1. That means it is written in normal present tense, okay, then ing form. So that is very important. Okay, continuous, that is what we use ing. So normal continuous tense, every verb will be in ing form plus object. So she has been writing a letter. That is the perfect sentence for present perfect continuous. Next one, negative rule, subject plus has or have plus not been, then the verb in ing, then object. She has not been writing a letter. Then interrogative rule, has or have plus subject plus, that is been our verb in ing form, then we have the object. That is, always I told you, interrogative is inversion type. So has she been writing a letter? Has she been writing a letter? Next one, interrogative negative rule. Next, so has or have, then that she, that is the subject, plus not plus been plus verb 1 in ing form plus object. So here example, has she not been writing a letter? So these are the four formats you would have seen for present simple tense or present tense. Okay, so like this we'll be continuing with the past tense and future tense. I hope so you would have understood everything clearly from this. Okay, we'll see in the next video with the past tense. Bye.